Okay, what we're going to try to do today, do a little import export, actually export import, but I'm going to run across a couple other things that'll help in this situation as well, and I'm also going to see if I can add some emitters in just to kind of show how that works. And then how you would import export that as well. Keep saying import export, but you have to export first. So basically, what we're going to start with is I'm going to go to this root folder in the map. What I've been trying to do, you want to have everything right at the top here on this particle systems emitters. I'm going to grab these fermenting silos. I'm going to copy here. I'm going to call this canola oil PS. Like so. And we're going to write back in. I'm going to grab this canola oil factory. I've got a work animation. And here's the particle section. So the easy way is to copy things in, but that'd be way too easy. I'm gonna show you how you need to actually add this in. So what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna hit Control D just to make another transform group quickly. I'm gonna hit Control X, click right back on that guy, hit Control V, and we're gonna call this guy exhaust, like so. And we're going to go to a string, and we need to look at another guy that has one, so I get this right. Work animation, PS. It is particle system file name, and the way most of the attributes work, it's a little confusing sometimes on Fabrik, but for example, in this one, it's lowercase, uppercase, uppercase, so particle system file name. Let's go back up here. I'm going to go particle system file name, like so. Make sure it's a string, and I hit add. So that basically gives this guy a path, what we're going to look for. What we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and, if I remember right, there's issues getting two of one emitter, but we're gonna try it anyway. I got a couple ideas here. So hit Control D to duplicate that. And we're gonna actually do a steam one as well. Control D to duplicate it again. And we can go back and actually rename this. We're gonna call it exhaust 2. We're gonna call this one steam. Alright. Now we're actually gonna go in. Morning there, Mimlar. I'm going to try to do a tutorial today. See how long it takes. We're going to go back into this canola oil particle system. We don't need the dust, so we can go ahead and get rid of the dust. Delete that. And what I'm going to try to do here is I'm actually going to grab this guy, open this up. I'm going to go file, export all the files, and we're going to keep it right in there, so that's good. We're going to call this exhaust particle system 2, just to see, because I had troubles with duplicate ones, so I'm going to see if this helps. I'm going to hit save. I don't want to get the parent directory. We're going to close that. We're going to copy this guy. We're going to call this particle 2, like so. We're going to get into this guy, particle 2. And we're going to hit save, close this. I'm going to go ahead and open it up and see what it looks like here, make sure there's no issues. We're going to open the console up. I don't see any errors down here, so that's a good start. Let me start zooming in and out. should start making some smoke. There we go. So yeah, we've got smoke. So I'm gonna close this guy. I don't want to save. Let's see if this helps or not. I don't know if it will, but being it's two separate particle systems, hopefully it'll help. They all use the same particle system shader. Yeah, so we should be good there. So what we're gonna do is gonna go back in. So that's gonna be kind of a twofold. I'm gonna show you how you can add emitters in and get them in the correct spot, because that can be a bear just as much as anything. So we're gonna go to steam first off, and we're gonna go particle system file name. So basically, music out of the way. I already closed that folder, so let's open it back up. Westbridge, particle systems, and we are looking for the canola oil. Alright, so basically, we want PS canola oil in the name of the system. Now, this is a little backwards way to do it. You could actually go to the folders and grab it, but I'm going to just go ahead and grab these two guys. Control C, Control V. Now, first thing is these slashes are wrong, so you have to switch them out. Alright, I'm going to add another one. And basically, we want, so this is going to be steam, which is actually smoke. I know it's backwards, but. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this file name. It's simpler to do this, that way you don't mess anything up. Control V. Alright. Particle system file name. I want to double check that to make sure I didn't screw that up. Particle system file name. Okay, cool. Back here. Alright, now here's a little cool thing I learned. This will screw your cranes up on your map if you save it. Well, we're not going to save it anyway, and we can always go back and re-import them, but anytime you do any kind of animation, like if you hit this play up here, that's what screws your cranes up, from what I've been told, and it seems to be pretty consistent. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to import the actual smoke. So let's go up here in the same one, which doesn't really matter where it imports, because I'm going to delete back out. And open that emitter up. I'm going to hit Control X. I'm going to minimize this guy. And we're going to go to Steam, Control V. Now here's the cool part. When I start grabbing this guy, he's actually going to start emitting to show you where you're actually. See how that smoke's coming out? Now you don't want to leave it in there, because it'll act goofy. It'll always be emitting in the game, even if this Fabrik script isn't running, and we only want to emit it when it's actually running. So we're just going to take this guy and we're going to place it. To give you an idea, the green arrow is basically where it usually emits. And a thing you have to watch, if you open up this emitter, like the exhaust, I had to straighten it out, because usually the exhaust is going to be shooting at an angle. So same thing here, when you scroll in, see how it's pointing straight up? You want to make sure all this stuff is zero, so that way when you're doing what I'm doing in game, it affects it that way. The older on 2015, it was a little different. You could use dual emitters, so you didn't really want to do this, but trust me, this is the best way to do it on this way that I found. I'm not saying I know how to do everything perfect, but this works great for me, because otherwise you'd be going in and out of the game, in and out of the game, trying to find out where in the heck this emitter is going to be, because in the end we're going to end up deleting this, so it's not even going to be there. So let's go ahead and crank this guy over. I just basically want to give an effect of the steam come out of the silo once running. Just something. It's just something different. I've been doing it with my edits I've been doing on some fermenting silos. I just think it makes it kind of a cool effect. So I'd say that looks fine right there. Just comes out of the top of the silo. It's going to come right back. We're actually going to delete that emitter. As you can see, like I said, now you have no idea where it is. You can sit here and grab this guy and move it around. Nothing happens. You just got this arrow and there's no reference point to it. That's what's frustrating. I'm going to hit Control Z to put it back. But yeah, you can't tell where in the world it's coming out of. When you rotate around in 3D, it's impossible. Unless some other things I use for a trick is cube stuff. So and I'll show that in another video. I think I'm gonna do another video on how to start from scratch. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna add exhaust to these two little generators. These are actually from the biogas. I guess to give you a rundown, this is obviously one of the smaller extension silos from in-game. I grabbed this compost from the Arches map from 2015. It's by Scooby and Marhu is what the credits say. This windmill, I think, is from, I actually grabbed it from PB Rivers 15, but I believe it's from Bjornholm. And this little guy here, it might even be from Bjornholm too, but I grabbed this from Arches as well. Anyway, back to what we're doing. And I turned the windmill off just to have less animation going on. So what we're going to do now is we're going to grab exhaust. So once again, we're going to import. I'm going to go to exhaust particle system. We're going to control X. I'm going to scroll back up, I'm going to go exhaust, control V. I'm going to grab this guy, and I'm going to see if we can position it off this muffler. And once again, should start getting, see how we're starting to get exhaust coming out of that green arrow? So first thing we want to do is we want to rotate that 90 degrees, like so. Now we should start having exhaust shooting out in the right direction. We're going to take him over. We're just going to try to line him up as best we can. We're going to slow down our navigation speed. Let's see what the heck we're doing. Slowly get there and get it in a pipe here. That'd be awesome. It's so hard to see sometimes in 3D view what's going on here. There we go. Alright. So we are in the pipe now. Somewhat centered. Alright, now you can see it's actually coming out of the sides of that pipe, so we're actually going to take it out. And, you know, kind of real life, usually your exhaust occurs out here anyway once it hits the atmosphere. So let's just kind of see what that looks like. Looks like it's pretty close to center. Get from the distance here. Pretty happy with that. Alright, so that guy is in order. So we're going to go ahead and get rid of... In fact, I'm going to try something here. I'm going to go ahead and import Exhaust Particle System 2. Control X. Control V. I actually want to grab these coordinates. We're going to click on that wire and hit Shift-Control-C to copy. Shift-Control-V to paste. What in the world? We got like a crazy... Oh, it's because it's the wrong way. And then we were at 90 degrees on the X-axis. 90. Okay. Let's make sure we grab this guy. Okay, cool. That might have been my problem. I had to have two separate particle systems. That's just weird, but it seems to be working, so we're going to go with it. We're going to roll with it. That's what I do on my labels, so. And continue to. There we go. Crank you up. Should be the same height. Let's copy this guy. Paste him back in. That'll at least get our height in there. We can just get centered up. Looks pretty close right there. Let's just go with that. Go Alright, so let's go back in and grab these emitters out of here and delete. Alright, now I'm gonna even go as far as put the small engine sound in there. So we're gonna go create audio source, go to our root menu, and there's usually in the maps there's sounds. This Tektron idle wave is what I want to go with. I'm gonna call this idle. I'm gonna hit Control X. I'm gonna go up to the sound. Control V. I think I can duplicate these guys without an issue. Control D. Bunker sound. I want to see what these guys. Let's go. The inner range is what's important. That's how far away it is before you hear it. I don't know the range, but I know the inner range is the big one. So we're going to go view, show, audio source, just so we can actually see all this mess over here. So the bunker sound is basically just the sound of the BGA. I'm going to grab this guy. We're going to control B. We're going to put him right here. Didn't quite do what I wanted, but once again, we're going to hit 20, 10. Put him right in here. That way, let me zoom in on it. So we hear it. If we zoom out there, we don't hear it anymore. So that's just what that's all about. Grab this guy, we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna go 20, 10. We're gonna control B, interactive place. And didn't do what I wanted, so we're gonna go ahead and just zoom all the way in here. Control B, interactive place. There we go. Alright. So that gives you your sound. We have particles. One more thing we're gonna do. Let's go back to view. I don't like seeing all that stuff. Turn off the audio source. Crank our speed back up. What we're gonna do is we're gonna grab these labels on the ground. I currently have these in a transform in the ground marker. And the reason I do that is when you shut off interactive markers, this stuff disappears. That way, if you don't want to be told exactly where everything's at and treat it like a noob, you can do that. But what I like to do is I like to leave it as an optional to export this stuff, because this actually could be a placeable, but your map would need canola oil. So anyway, I'm going to grab this sign and then control C to copy it. I'm going to grab a visible. There we go. So we get into the right transform. So visible objects is where you want to put any kind of decals or any kind of buildings, anything that doesn't function in the Fabrik script. So we're going to hit Control V to paste it. We're going to grab this guy. We're going to zoom around. We're just going to basically put it right back on the ground where it is currently at. Just so it pops out of the ground. There we go. This actually should be able to be zero. I'm not quite sure why it's off the ground. We're going to stick with that right there. Alright, so I'm just going to basically, because I have triggers already lined up with this guy, I just want to get him close because the other one's not going to pull out. That's close enough for that guy. I'm going to grab the load compost sign. Do the same thing, control C, and go back up to visual. Let's minimize this guy. Visual object, control V. And actually, let's take this guy and steal that Y axis, control C, to mess with that again. Control V. Just gonna zip this on out. This guy needs to be rotated 180 degrees off the Y. Get a good look at it here. See how this guy looks like? Oh, needs to be a negative. That's why. Sometimes when you copy, if you don't grab the whole cell, it does that to you. That's pretty close. And actually, the easiest way is you can actually line up with that silo trigger and bring it back down. Okay, so there's that guy, and we're going to grab one more label. Canola dump. Control C. Visual here. There we go. Control V. Once again, I'm going to grab this tire Y axis. Control C. Control V. And once again, we'll kind of place this guy right on top of the old one. Just like that. Alright. So now we have everything in place, we should be able to export this guy. So what we're going to do is we're going to minimize everything, and let's just double check here. Let's go through our tree and make sure we don't have any problems, because I added some stuff. Work animation. So basically it starts at zero, so you have your particle should be zero. Oops, should be zero. So particle index zero. Animation, we don't have any, so we wouldn't have to have it in there, but it's 0, 1, so it's 1. Sound would be 0, 1, 2. There's our 2. And then shader is 0, 1, 2, 3. And shader 3. So we have everything we need. Let's go ahead, and once again, we'll just minimize this guy. We're going to select that entire fabric. And I put save IDs in here, that way I can find them in the equipment. XML a lot easier if I gotta do some testing. So just a suggestion to add the save ID in there. If not, it goes off the primary name, but just an idea. So we're gonna grab this guy, we're gonna hit file, we're going to export selection with files. I'm gonna go to my desktop. I like to put it in an easy place to find, and I like to move files completely, that way it's not pulling them files from another location, causing texture issues. So we're on the desktop, we're going to go new folder, we're going to canola oil, enter, canola oil. We're going to go ahead and save. We'll hit no, and we should not need this map anymore, so we're going to go ahead and close it. Alright. And the one thing we're going to have to make sure we grab is everything's in here. We're going to have sounds and everything, but we're not going to have that particle system. So what we're going to do, just to have it along with us, we're just going to go back in there. We're going to grab this canola oil PS. We're just going to copy it here. All right, we're going to close that. We're done with that folder. And now, here's the fun part. This is where you've got all these folders. And we're going to simplify it a little bit. The shader's alright, but I like to clean this up. It takes a little bit of time, but trust me, in the end, it's so much easier when you want to start finding things. Basically, everything can go in that textures, because if we go in here, oh, not that folder. You got decals, you got blank DDS. These are almost all DDS files. So, like I said, we're going to go and clean this all up. We already got the textures. In fact, we already have an issue here. I want to pull these guys all out. So I'm going to hit cut, go back to textures, paste. It's a good practice to right click on that folder just to make sure there's nothing in there, so you're not deleting the file you need. Go back here. Alright, we're just going to go ahead, and from here I'm just going to hit open a new window so I can start transferring this stuff over. I don't know why I keep grabbing that canola oil one. I don't need that. I should have waited to bring that in, I guess. Alright, so we're going to go to import, thinner oil building, texture. We're going to go ahead and grab these. We're going to move them in there. Alright, import. So we're done with that one. I'm going to go ahead and delete them. Decal, blank. I'm going to move that in. Thinner oil decal. Move that in. Compost. Dump canola, cyan canola. Alright, so that's all the decals. And once again, to be sure, okay, properties. As you can see, we have zero files, and so we can go ahead and delete that guy. Yes. Gonna go display, canola oil display. Alright, move that guy in. This is probably going to already be there. We're going to hit move. Oh, maybe not. Alright, so we have our displays done. Delete that guy. Yes. Hose coupling. Textures. Move. Delete. Pipe. That's what I'm talking about. You get all these folders, it gets confusing later on. It's just nice to have it all cleaned up. Just my opinion. Put that guy. Got planes. Put that there. Sawmill. As you can see, this is ridiculous. Move that in there. Building. Models. Yeah, see, this is insane. I think I got everything in there. Yeah. Oops. Gonna grab this guy. Move. And this is fine. I'm just gonna hit do not move. It's already in there. Don't move. So, sawmill. Import. So them guys are both gone, so we can go ahead and delete the import. Yes. Gonna leave the shaders alone. What you want to do is, on these shaders, there's some file pathing here, so we're gonna make sure we have everything right. So we're gonna go ahead and open these guys up. Alright, mesh rotate. There's no file pathing in here that I can see. Number, I don't see one, and actually we'll go to this one to show you what I'm talking about. See how there's a default file name? So what this means is it wants to go up a folder, look for share folder, and then it's dirt normal. As you can see, this one doesn't have one, so we'll go ahead and close it. So basically, we're inside the shaders. So if you go up from shaders, it's looking for shared, I believe it was. Bring this up so you can see it. Yep, shared, which is there, and it's looking for dirt normal. We go in there, dirt normal. So that one's good. You could move that if you want, but we'll leave it alone for now. It's a standard way to do that. So, shader's okay, shared's okay, sound we're going to leave alone. And then textures. As you can see, all them files went into one folder that way. So we're going to go ahead and close this guy down. Now, we're going to get into the fun part. We're going to right-click this guy. We're going to edit him in Notepad++. You can see, look at all this mess. I mean, them are all folders it's looking for. So we're just going to clean it up. We're going to grab, we know it's textures. If you want to be safe, you can grab this guy, copy that folder name. And we're just going to go ahead and we're going to get rid of this stuff. We're going to hit Control C to copy, Control F to find. We're going to replace, Control V to paste, and we want to replace it with textures. So I'm just going ahead and hit it. The safe way to do it is hit Find Next, Replace, and go to the next one if there was one. There is no other one, so we're good. I'm going to go ahead and grab this guy. Control-C. Control-V. And we're going to hit, I'm just going to hit Replace All. There's only one line again. And if it's only one line like that, I mean, you can actually copy that guy. You can double-click, delete. Actually, delete again, double click, delete, delete, double click, delete, and then hit Control V to add the textures in. As you can see, there's a bunch of single lines, so it's about as quick to do it that way. So paste that in. Now we have a couple of identical ones, so we'll just go ahead and go back to this. And even though it's just textures, you got to look at it, it's a capital T, and it's very important, especially in FS17 now, especially when it gets zipped. That'll mess it up. So we're just gonna replace that whole line again. Control C to copy. Control V. Gonna hit replace all. Go back. Yeah, that's a long one there. And we're just gonna go all the way over. Even though the texture's already there, we're just gonna use it anyway. Control C. Control V. Replace all. Control C. V, place all. Control C, Control V, place all. Control C, Control V, place all. Hello, big man, how's it going, bud? Control C, Control V, place all. This one's already got textures in there, so we're just going to do that one. Copy that. Paste. Place all. We're going to leave sounds go, because that's in there. That's good to hear, bud. Good to hear. Alright, we're going to go ahead and just do this again. Control C. Paste. Place all. Shaders are okay because it's a root folder. So now we should be good. We're going to go ahead and hit save. If you want to be safe, you could have pulled that file out, but knock on wood, you don't mess it up too bad here. Hey, NC, how's it going, bud? Alright, so we're going to go ahead and close this guy out. Now we're actually going to open it up in the actual Giants editor. Right off the bat, don't freak out. What's going on here is it's picking it up where it was on the map. So if I click on this guy, you can see the translations is way off. We're going to fix that. But first of all, before we do anything at all, we're on the window console. So make sure we don't have any weird errors. Because, you know, it doesn't say error loading texture. Which, we're good. I don't know what this, I have to do some investigating with this GLAMD depth clamp separate, not supported. I got to check that out. But we don't have any errors here. So that's a good thing. So we can go ahead and get rid of the console. I'm going to click on this guy. We're going to go ahead and just zero these out. And look at that. Ta-da. We have a factory setting in front of us. A manufactured factory. So we're going to go ahead and hit save. As soon as it says ready, we're good to go. So we're going to close this. I just downloaded the update on this map. So what I'm going to do... apologize for doing this live, but go to this dondeigo map is what I'm messing with. Actually, we're going to open this zip up. I'm going to go ahead and delete this guy. Yes. All right, I'm going to take this to there. Grab this guy, and this guy. I'm going to move them over here. Boo-hoo, please. And do I have any identical? Okay, I should have deleted some of this stuff first. Alright. Now this guy I want to actually zip out. Okay, it's actually extracting it. Or not. Let's go ahead and extract to. Alright. While I'm waiting for that, I might as well just leave this go. So I should add this done already. But yeah, and so you know, I mean, most of you guys know, to edit a map, you have to have it extracted. That's one thing you can't do inside of a zip, even with WinRAR. So it's extracted. We're going to go ahead and delete the actual zip file. All right. Now, we have our canola oil here. So what we're going to do is we're going to double-click here. And we're going to go right off the bat. Remember I talked about this PS. We're going to open that up. We're going to open the canola oil up. And we're just going to copy this particle right into here. Copy here. And then everything else we can put right in the actual map. And what I've been trying to do on this map is an actual import. So we can actually go back to the root folder. We're actually going to just copy it right in here like so. Make sure it went in there, canola oil. Cool. So we're in the map. So maps. Now here's the other thing. I'm going to show you how to add materials. So we're going to go to mod descript, which is up here. And we're going to start adding material. So here's the actual fruit name. We're going to copy this line, paste it in. It's just canola oil. Same thing. I'm going to go lowercase on the first word, uppercase on the second. And this is what you want to show up in text. So we're going to go ahead and hit canola oil. And then I'm going to get rid of the German for now because I have no idea what it is in German. I could actually probably look it up. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to search for the additional trigger. It's right here. What we have to do is I'm going to actually cheat here. You can find this in the actual GE. Let's open it back up again here. But if you have another template to go off of, that's awesome. Come on, open up. Being a little slow today. So what we're looking for is the actual output trigger. And yeah, here's the canola oil. So the liquid trigger, this is some definitions here. It's basically saying the liquid name, liquid canola oil, and then the fill type, which is canola oil. I think that's the only part. So what you have to do is additional trigger. And what the best way, man, is to download another Fabrik mod that uses the liquid triggers. A little goofy because you also have the automatic triggers from the silo trigger, but that's going to already be in the map. See, there's your automatic trigger, silo trigger. See, it has all this information here. The start text, stop text, to automatic text, to manual text. That stuff needs to be in your mod descript. So basically, this one doesn't, I don't see, there might be a liquid trigger. Yeah, here we go. Start pig food, stop pig food, liquid milk start, liquid milk stop. So actually, we can actually just copy these lines right here because that's the same thing we're looking for. We're going to hit Control C and come right up here. I'm going to add a line, Control V, and this is actually going to be, let's go ahead and copy it so I don't misspell it. Control C. Control V. Control V, and then we're going to get rid of the German. There we go. And we're going to hit, what I like to do is I like to start let's see what I do actually do on mine, just for the hell of it. Westbridge, line descript, from F, start. Yeah. Yes, I hit start loading and stop loading is what I usually do. So let's just go ahead and do that again. Where do we go here? So I'm going to go, this is going to be start loading canola oil. Copy this. Paste it in. And this is going to be stop. There's your stop, your start. So that's it for the additional trigger for the liquid trigger. I don't usually add the automatic because it already has get out for automatic charging and the actual command for automatic charging, so we don't need to add that in. If this was your first mod with additional triggers, it does have to be added, but we're not going to mess with that. And that's usually right in the descriptions. If you look at the Fabrik script, there's some tutorials on that stuff. Hey, big man, this is just a canola oil factory. Sorry, bud. So I'm dwarfed here. So we got the additional trigger added. Now we need to control C. What we're gonna do is we're control F. We're gonna see where else cotton is. Find next. So this is where the actual materials are. Now, cool thing is, yeah, we have to copy another material, and I'm gonna copy beer for now. Control C. Add a line. Control V. With the wrap, I can see a lot better. Wrap. Okay. This is going to be. Oop. Control Z on, do that. I was going to copy this in, but canola oil. And we'll jack this price up a little bit more. Not a whole lot. We're not going to mess with that. Has group bulk. Has group liquid. This is true. See, this has changed. This isn't, the old one was a little different. I gotta look at that now. Yeah, this is going to be interesting. Or if they changed add map types. So I'm going to have to do a little bit of adjustment here, because here's the mod descript. Has particles heap. And here's whiskey. Yeah, see, fill type categories, bulk liquids, they changed it on this one here. What's the add map type on this guy? Close him. Let's go to scripts, add additional map types. It's 1.007. Sorry, I'm going through this. It's kind of. Let's see. Scripts. I don't know. It's just weird. They changed the way it registers, though. Very odd. Let's get rid of that guy. Well. Okay. So it has group liquid true. Where's beer at? Has group liquid false. The one on that, mass per liter. This is a little confusing as well, but it must be because it's a liquid, it's a little different. Not necessarily, it's 400.08, so that's a little odd. Anyway, so it has group unknown false, group bulk true. Group liquid true. It's not a windrow, not a piece, not a combine, not a forage. Has group slurry tank false. I think we're good on everything else.
That's just a little weird that they changed it from last map. I wonder if they had some issues there. Sorry, anyway. So now it is registered. This will tell it basically it'll go in a tank, is what this has group liquid's all about. Alright, so sorry about all that, but I'm going to go ahead and save the mod to script. Get out of here. That was extended a little much. Get back out of here. Just to kind of back out, and we're going to go ahead and close this guy. I'm not going to save it. We're going to open the map. So Diego. Maps, map. Now what I suggest doing is, I'm not completely familiar with this map yet, but usually you want to have like a factory transform or something. So what I would usually do is I'd hit create. Transform group, this is when I'm going to start adding my factories, for example. So you could actually type in fab, or actually better yet, fab factories. There's more on this map, but I'm just giving you an idea. So then we're going to actually import. We're going to go start from scratch. We're going to watch where we pull this in at. So I know that I'm in this folder. Dondeigo, we're going to import canola oil, there's the I3D, we're going to go ahead and hit control X, I'll put in this guy, control V. You want to keep this guy at zero here, you don't want to mess that one up, we want to grab this canola oil though. We're going to find a good spot to put it, which I'm going to put it right over here for now, just for testing reasons. We're going to hit them, hit control B to interactive place, click on there. Alright, first thing we want to do is we're going to rotate this guy by 90 degrees. That doesn't look too bad, let's make sure we're not into the fences back here. I'm going to grab this arrow and just kind of move them out so our trigger, our saddle trigger is not all messed up. Alright, so that ought to be simple enough, gives us some room to drive around. Yeah, it's good enough. So, everything should be in place. Like I said, we put the PS system where it needs to be. The particle emitters and everything. So we're going to actually go into the map here. We're going to test this guy. Yeah, we've added the canola oil to the map. So let's just go ahead and hit save. And let's see if we get any errors when we go back in. In fact, once this gets done exporting, I want to go to the console, make sure I didn't have any errors either. Let's go window, console. And I don't see any errors, so we're good there. Close, minimize this guy. I'm going to bring up my mod selector. I got a video on how to do this, guys. If you haven't seen that, this mod selector is very nice to use. So we're going to hit Dondeigo.
Gonna open the game. A career. We're going to actually. We're gonna delete a couple of these game save. Yes. Delete. Yes. Gonna go ahead and use this guy. Start. First thing first, once this thing boots up, another cool feature you can use with the mod selector, if it boots up, a lot of factors in this guy. Didn't see any here right off the bat, but I'm going to go ahead and escape, go to monitor here, and we're going to go to the log, like so. Make sure we're at the top, control F. Error. Oh, see, I already forgot one thing. I forgot about the stupid HUDs, so no big deal. Okay. And it's not loading the particle system, so I gotta look to see what I did wrong there. Failed to load particle system. Thought I moved it in, maybe I didn't. Alright, first off, let's go ahead and let's do a save game. That way I can go in and add some canola. So let's close this. Can't believe I forgot the stupid canola oil. Alright. I'm not going to get into making a HUD file today, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy it from my map. Westbridge. Fruit HUD. There's canola oil. Canola oil small. I'm going to copy this guy. And here you go. We're going to go ahead and just paste it in there. And an important note here. So what you have is you have fill and you have fruit. The canola oil is a fill, not a fruit. Just to keep that clear. So that is done. Now why didn't the particles load? Get rid of that folder. So I'm gonna go dondeigo PS canola. Oh yeah, I know what the problem is. I never put them in there. Smart. So I'm actually gonna go back out here and do it first. I got ahead of myself. Yeah. It helps if you have the actual particle system in there, huh? This guy got added in, but I forgot the other one. So canola oil. So that guy's in, but we need to add the two exhaust systems in. So canola oil. We need exhaust system one. So let's go ahead and do this. I started to do it and started jabbering on. Sorry about that. Exhaust system one. What we're going to do is we're actually going to grab this whole line here, copy it, paste. We're going to get rid of this I3D. We want exhaust particle system one, so we're going to copy this whole thing here, control C, back to here, control V. Once again, we're going to grab this whole line, control C, go into here, control V. This is system 2. Save. And that was our export. I want that for later reasons. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to pull this like this. Get it out of my way. We're going to bring up the map. We're going to do the same thing. Canola oil. Work animation. Particle systems. Shrink him down. Alright, so exhaust, grab this, control C, control V, control C, control V, the steam should actually be there, control C,
Yeah, so that guy's there, so we're good there. Alright, let's try this again. Close him. Make sure you always select off of that after you put something in. Sometimes it won't save. You're going to hit save. Hey, Donna, how's it going? So early, huh? It's a good thing about it in air like that. I can show you how if you mess up, you can find it. Okay, open the game back up. We'll try this again. I actually forgot to add product to the silo. There might actually be some already. So we're going to go save game 4. Start. Start. Let's go back out. Check for errors. Log. F. Error. Cool. Fixed our errors. Check for warnings. That's just because it's not zipped. No big deal. And we have no warnings. So let's just double check. Go to the top. Okay. Cool. So we are flawless there. Turn back off my monitor. Go back into the game. And we got to get us some money. We're going to purchase a truck. Cool little job that NC did here with the AR stuff. Check out my mod links to get that. Then we're going to go tippers. Buy an AR tipper. Alright, I'm going to grab this guy. Let's see if we can get to the farm without crashing and burning here. Let's go like here. That wasn't too bad of a land. Teleport mod, gotta love it. Alright, hopefully we got some canola in the silo here. Yes, we do. Cool. Alright, so we're gonna crank around over here. We're gonna dump the canola. Like so. Quick. And let's crank our speed up real quick here. Till the display comes on, hopefully. There it is. So we are making compost and canola. Simple as that. As you see, we have resource. Sometimes the first couple of times you have to hit F1 a couple of times to get it right. But resource canola, products, compost, canola oil. Now let's go make sure everything looks right. Looks like we got a good display there. So we have 12,585. 12,585. Registering canola oil. As you can see, our emitter's working. I almost forgot. So it's kind of cool. Our exhaust coming out. We got a motor. I don't hear this motor. I bet you it's the same thing. I probably have to name it something different. So that's a thought. No. I bet you it has to be motor 2 or something. We can go play with that. But we are getting 2. If I can get up on this building. Don't look like it. Either way, we're getting exhaust. What we can do quick is we can go into dev mode here. Go into flight mode. That doesn't look too shabby. Looks like it's coming out of the exhaust okay. Fly up here a little higher. Not look too bad. Got the moaning and groaning sound. Oh, for some reason the sound is way over here. That's what's going on with that. Must have been off. So I'll have to look at that and see why that's so goofy. One other thing though, before I even do that, let's go buy a truck. Yes, okay. Let's see if we can do this again without crashing and burning. And cross your fingers, yep, we're good. Pull up here, we should get a start fill. We're not. Is this guy interesting? Oh, you know what? Is this only a water truck now? No. Yeah, I bet you the bulk is not set right. I gotta change the liquid. Let's get them out of here just to double check. Let's go ahead and buy. And universal tank. Buy. Just to double check something here. Yep, so I don't have something registered right. So alright, we got a couple of things to fix. We'll fix that. Go ahead and save game. Close that. So what's going on with sound? Yeah, it shows it being right there. Idle. Oh, nope, I never moved the other one. That goes there. That'd be why. Alright, so go ahead and save that guy. Canola oil, let's open him back up. So we have Control C. The idle 2. Control C. Control V. Go ahead and save this guy again. Close him out. I wasn't getting a fruit error, so just go make sure on output trigger. Output trigger 2. Canola oil, liquid trigger, canola oil. So we should be good there. We just have to look at our mod descript, see what's going on here. Problem. I spelled it wrong there. Where else did I spell it wrong? Control F. Spell right there. Spell right there. Spell right there. Alright. That might have been half the problem, though. Has group liquid. True. Has group bulk. True. Bulk, windrow, train, auto weapon. I think that fill type categories is something I have to. I'm gonna go with maybe that trigger was messing me up. Hit save. Open this guy up again. So this changed a little bit from. The last version. See, we're still not getting our trigger to pop up. Alright. Back out of here. Close. What we're gonna do is we're gonna grab compost. Copy. .9 true liters per second, mass per liter, 100 use for spray, false. Go ahead and delete this guy out. Two categories, true. Fill type category. I'm going to go bulk and liquid. I'm going to leave that alone. Use heat. That's going to be false. All this stuff is fine. Hit save. See if that fixes it. See, it's easy if you're just adding something and it's just a solid material, but being it's a new liquid like that, it makes it a little more difficult. I could have just copied it from my other version that I already done on the whiskey, but that'd be too easy. Just make sure we don't throw any errors here. Log. Whenever you change something, always double check this. Okay, there are no errors. Good there. I can't ever have a flawless video, can I? Alright. Let's go back in. There we go. And actually, if I remember right, it's going to hook up right there. Yep. So we got canola oil. Go grab that other truck just to make sure. Sorry about that, I just had it registered wrong. There we go. Start, stop. And actually, let's speed up time. Probably. Yeah, I'm already going to be out of canola, probably. I want to make sure I get a stop. It happens so fast. So start, stop. Okay, cool. Okay, guys, so that was that. That's how you export and import, as long as you get your fruit registration right, which, shame on me for messing that up. But it's a little difficult when you're adding a liquid like that. It's a little more in depth. So that's how that
works, guys. Hopefully this was helpful. I'm gonna try to keep putting on a couple of tutorials like this every once in a while. I got a couple other ideas I want to add in, but I've had a few people ask me about exporting some of the buildings I've put on the Westbridge map. I'll put a link to Grabbylatoosh. He's got a copy of this map. I'll probably put that on the video if I get his permission. I'll put a link to the map I've been editing as well, and the Marhu site, because that without Marhu, guys, this whole Fabrik thing just wouldn't exist. So anyway, anyone watching live right now, I'm going to stop the stream and I'll just restart it back up here in a little bit. So just hang out there, guys. I will be right back. To you two people, we'll see you next time.